Is this thing on? Oh, it's so dark in here. I wish there was something I could do about it. Oh wait, I'm God. Let there be light.
So basically, on the first day, I created light and darkness. It wasn't too hard. And then the next day, I separated the water in the sky from the water on the earth. And I forgot to turn the camera on, so there's no footage, but trust me, it happened. Then after that, I created the land and the sea and the plants, each one of them with seed according to its kind. Next, I made the sun and the moon. That was pretty fun. For the next 2 days, I created all the birds and the animals and the fish, and let me tell you, there was a lot of them.
Moo!
Overall, I would say it was good, it was pretty good, but there was something missing, something that I wanted to do a little bit more. I wanted to create something special, something created in my own image. So I got down in the dirt and I did what I do best, which technically is everything, but you know, can't give away any secrets.
Okay, so the garden has been great so far. I get to hang out with God, which is so sick. I got to name all the animals, which I'm so happy about. And I can eat whatever I want. Okay, maybe not everything, but you get the point.
The garden's been great. And it's awesome hanging out with the animals, but I've noticed some things with the animals. I feel so lonely.
So, I had an idea. Picture this. Women.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I
wonder
what you are.
So, I met this girl.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy about Adam. Like, good job, God. Totally my type. I'm having a great time. So glad to be alive. I just hope nothing bad happens.
Why am I here? Well, I'm about to end this man's whole career.
Did God really say you can't improve any of the trees?
No, he didn't say that. He said, you can eat from all the trees except for that one, or else we'll die.
You're not gonna die. God just doesn't want you to be like him and know the difference between good and evil.
Man, it's gonna take him so long to find all the fish I made, and the animals, and the bird.
God, you know that tree?
Not the tree! I knew this would happen! No! 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 Where are they? Where are they? Are they hiding? Oh! Adam! Eve! Where are you?
We're hiding!
Hiding? Why are you hiding?
Because we're naked!
Naked? Who told you you were naked? Did you eat the fruit?
Eve gave it to me.
Well, the serpent made me do it.
Disgusting. No more legs for you.
Sup, I'm Enoch.
You know, things have been pretty quiet since Adam and Eve screwed everything up. Well, actually, there was that one time.
No, no, don't!
Bet you're not able to get out of this one, huh? Ah! Ah! Ah!
Humanity's just gotten so wicked.
Oh! I'm totally wicked!
Man, these mere mortals. If only I could, like, start over. Oh, wait. I have an idea.
You know, I'm just out here living my best life. Sure, the neighbors are murderers and thieves, but, like, that's totally fine. You know, I'm sure they're just misunderstood. You know, I just get to do life with my wonderful wife and our three just wonderful, beautiful sons, Shem, Ham, Japheth. I love you guys. You know, I just love them so much. You know, I may be 500, but to be honest, I don't feel a day over 370.
Look! It's from God.
From God?
Yeah.
What does it say?
I'll open it.
What the freak?
Honey!
So, it's been almost 100 years. The boat's been going great, though. Knock on wood. My wife's been super supportive of my hobbies. I do feel bad because, you know, I haven't had that much time for her, which is unfortunate. But.
So it's been hard. Really, really hard. I can only keep a fake smile on my face for so many decades. you know, he just said it's gonna be a hobby. I'm really trying to be supportive, but.
Yeah, the boat building's been going great.
Yeah, I've totally loved spending some quality time with Dad.
What's up, I'm Ham. Some people call me Meat Stick. It's fine, I guess. I try not to let it get to me that much, but like sometimes I feel like people treat me different because of my name. Like I'm really just the hardest worker of everybody else. Like I don't know, sometimes it's kind of frustrating, you know, because like, oh, Ham, you know, look what we're having for supper. It's bacon. You can't eat it. You'd be a freaking cannibal. I don't want to be a cannibal. I just want to be a guy who can eat ham. I just want to eat bacon.
You know, I've seen people treat me like a piece of meat. This is ham.
What was the question? Oh, yeah, so we're building a boat.
Jack, the Amazon package came in the mail.
The Amazon package?
Yeah. Oh, my cheetahs and gazelles, they're here.
Guys, we may have to reorder those gazelles.
I'm only 447 years old, and I'm already getting gray hairs because of this man.
All right, so today's the big day. Forecast is calling for sunny, but God told me otherwise. Onto the boat.
Shut up. I'm literally going to tell Dad.
You know what I like
green
eggs?
What? Ham?
Ham?
Shut up! It's not that funny!
It is though.
It's been about 150 days since the rain started, and we can finally see the tops of the mountains. We've been getting really bored, but we're just happy to be alive.
Guys, I think it's almost time for us to get off this boat. I think I'll send a raven off to see if we can find any land. I don't think that's coming back. Let's try a dove instead. This one's good.
Okay. Go find some land. I hope he comes back.
So, sent out the raven, and he did not come back. I think he's dead. But I sent out the dove, and he did come back with this. This is a good sign. And then I sent him out again, and he didn't come back. So, that can only mean one thing. I think we're close.
Guys, this is a symbol that whenever we see it, we'll know that God is faithful to his promises.
Man, it's beautiful.
Hi there, my name's Abram. You've actually caught us at a really interesting time. You see, last night, God told me to look up at the stars, and he said that my kids would outnumber them. That's whack. Especially considering I'm really old. I'm good to go, though. My wife, on the other hand, she's, let's just say the factory has not running at full capacity. Or any capacity.
But that's okay, though, because he's going to take my maid servant, Hagar. It's a perfect solution, really. Me? Jealous? No, not at all. Actually, I'd say quite the opposite. Honestly, I'd say I'm handling this situation very maturely.
Sarah? Love her. She's literally so, so gorgeous. I hope I look like her when I'm her age. But anyway, am I showing yet?
She said that? My age? My age? That's it. Oh my word. Get up. Get up.
Sarah.
You're done.
Sarah.
You're done.
What?
Get out of here.
Sarah.
No. You were totally into her.
It was your idea!
Yeah, well, I changed my mind.
Anyway, it's water underneath the ground. We don't know where it is. But the other day, some angels came to our house, and they were like, Sarah and you are gonna have a son this time next year. Which is really weird for two reasons. We're old. Really old. And number two, they changed our names to Sarah and Abraham. I'm trusting that God will keep his promises, though. Yeah. But imagine laughing at the God's promises.
Seriously? I didn't do it!
She did. Anyway, my nephew Lot.
Oh, hey. We're about to go warn Lot and his family that we're about to blow this popsicle stand because they're evil. Lot! We have a message from the Lord.
Oh yeah, come on in!
Last night I saw a few like really good looking guys go into Lot's house. So I followed them, and I like knocked on Lot's door and everything, and then one of them opened it up, and I guess I'm blind now. So I'm gonna change absolutely nothing about my lifestyle.
You need to leave! And whatever you do, don't look back! Oh crap. Popsicle stand equals blown.
Don't worry, guys. Lot's fine. I thought about making a joke about salt, but NA, nah. Too soon? The factory is back in business, baby!
He's beautiful. Just beautiful. We named him Isaac because, well, I'll admit, I did kind of laugh when God promised us a child.
I'm so stoked to be a dad. I can't wait to live out my dreams of being a father. You know, teaching him how to kick around the old pigskin, teaching him how to walk, circumcising him. Normal dad stuff. So, not sure what God is doing here, but I'm heading up the mountain with my son to sacrifice him because God told me to.
Hey, so I'm super excited to go up the mountain with my dad today. He said that we're doing a sacrifice, which I'm kind of confused because we're not bringing an animal, but he said that it's okay. So, yeah, I'll tell you guys how it goes once I get back.
What's new? Well, for starters, I have 12 boys now. Anyways, I know I'm not supposed to have favorites, but I have this one really nice coat.
Hey, Joseph, come here. I have something for you.
What's good, Papa?
I made this really special coat just for you.
For me?
Don't worry about wearing it in front of your brothers. They already know I love you more, so it shouldn't matter.
Yay! Thanks, Dad. My coat? Yeah, I got it from my dad. He's pretty cool.
Yeah, I'm definitely his favorite child. My brothers are okay too, they're pretty cool. Sometimes they just say mean things. I don't know why though.
That kid is so annoying. He always gets what he wants, he always gets the best clothes, and he never gives up his harp.
Guys, guess what?
Oh my goodness, Joseph, what?
I had a really cool dream last night. We were all bundling grain, like you guys are doing, and then all of your bundles of grain bowed down to my bundle of grain. Isn't that so cool?
No, Joseph, it's not. It's grain, you idiot. Get lost.
The dreams, hey? Yeah, I don't know how I feel about that. He came to me the other day and told me about one where the sun, moon, and stars bow down to him. Yeah, that kid's got a mouth on him. I don't know quite what to do.
Hey, Joseph.
Hey, Dad.
Your brothers are out tending the sheep in the fields.
Yeah.
I'm gonna send you to check in on them.
Oh, okay, cool. I'll just get packed really quick.
Man, this is gonna be such a fun trip. Just me, God, and obviously my music.
It's so nice and quiet here without Joseph here.
Yeah, that kid riles me up.
He's definitely not my favorite, but he's not the worst thing ever. Going to the market and having to wait 10 minutes for your friends, that's the worst.
Yeah, but him and his music, it's so annoying.
I would like to reach out my hand all myself on the day.
Speaking of, why is he here?
Wait, I have an idea.
Finally got rid of that kid. Well, we thought of killing him, but Reuben convinced me that we should sell him. So we got the money, and now all we have to do is convince Dad we didn't do anything.
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I guess I'm glad he's gone. I got some money out of it too, so that's sick.
Well, that was unexpected. I guess I'm a slave now. That kind of sucks. I hope everything works out though. Yeah, this is definitely a low point in my life.
I mean, Joseph? I mean, love the kid. I mean, he's handsome. I mean, he works so hard. He loves his God. He stays faithful to his God. I mean, he's really handsome. And I think I can just put him anywhere. And I just trust he's just going to do just a fantastic job. I mean, he's just handsome. I mean, my wife and I are just really excited to have him in our house. I mean, she seems like really excited, but like, overall, I think we're just both really, really happy to have him. I mean, we're just really happy.
The new slave boy, Joseph?
Yeah, he's great. Love to watch him work.
Hey.
Hi.
Come sleep with me.
No, I'm gonna go draw my map.
That freaking Hebrew. If I can't have him, no one can. I told Potiphar that he came on to me. He was so mad.
She said what?
The buffoonery is endless. He infiltrates my home, and now he's trying to sleep with my wife? Just, you know, fair warning, Joseph. Hope you like prison, loser. You're handsome, though. Bye.
Yeah, this year has definitely not been the greatest. I mean, I've been in prison, so. But I've definitely learned to just trust in God and give him the glory. As some bonus good news, I think I'm about to get out of this joint. God helped me decipher Pharaoh's dream. I guess Pharaoh thought that was pretty cool, so he's going to make me second in command over all Egypt.
Joseph,
That guy rocks. He's gonna help, like, save Egypt. I put him in charge of everything so that I can just sit back. Once he interpreted my dream, I knew he had to have the power.
Hey guys, we ran out of grain. I heard that Egypt has some grain, so I'm sending you guys to go to Egypt because we need more grain.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Sounds good. Let's go. Who are you? Where did you come from?
We are 12 brothers of one man. We are from Canaan, and one of us has died.
You think one of you have died, but I am him.
Joseph, I thought you were dead.
Hey, Benji. Missed you too, bro.
See, what our brothers here meant for evil, God meant for good. So he protected me through it all.
Wow. Plot twist.
Something about Moses? Yeah, I don't know. My life's pretty great. My parents, they're super great. They've always been really supportive of all my hobbies like guitar playing and table making. Yeah, I just love them so much.
Of all the oceans in the world, my favorite is the Red Sea.
It's really sensitive, boy.
So, we haven't actually told him that he's adopted yet. There's just never a good time.
Today is the day.
Hey, Dad. What's up?
Just wanted to let you know, you're adopted.
Yeah.
Do you have anything after
that? No, you're just not our son.
Yeah.
Like, we still love you and stuff, but,
You're also bad at good time.
Yeah, so, turns out, I'm an Israelite. Who would have thought?
Hey! Those are my people!
I gotta get out of this town.
Stop following me!
Yeah, my life's been really great since I left Egypt. I'm a shepherd, I have a new family, I'm in anger management classes. Yeah, I've really found my true calling, shepherding. I'm just so glad I left Egypt.
I'm sending you to Pharaoh to bring my people out of Egypt. And take those trendy boots off. You're on holy ground.
But why me? You know I'm just a shepherd boy. I have stage fright.
You will have signs that will prove you were sent by me. Aaron will help you too. He will speak to the people for you, and it will be as if he were your mouth. And if that doesn't work, just picture the crowd naked. It works every time.
Yeah, it's been great seeing Aaron and hanging out with him, but he just won't stop talking. It's like he's speaking for me or something.
Yeah, Moses is a pretty cool guy. Super excited to be talking for him and over him and under him and beside him and around him. Like, honestly, just I love talking. Like,
I'm Aaron. So nice to meet you. Little predicament. Not even a predicament.
So, he's not letting the people go.
I don't really know who this Moses guy thinks he is.
We've tried everything. 9 plagues, and the Pharaoh still won't let the people go.
They've been trying all sorts of stuff with this staff, and it turned you into a snake. Like, it's fine. And then, like, the locusts. You know, it's not that big of a deal, swat, bug spray. Like, my magicians, they can do those stuff too. Like, I'm not that impressed. I don't feel threatened. Like, I, It's not that good. I'm not worried.
Time to bring out the big guns.
Oh, sweet. I knew heaven would be like this.
Look at this guy. He knows what's up. Pepsi over Coke, am I right?
Hey guys, I'm the Angel of Death. I'm really excited to be here and just looking forward to doing whatever I can to serve God.
I think you're good. Yeah, the camera was off during filming, but we just crossed the Red Sea. It was really cool to see God work in his amazing ways. And it was just a simple two-step instruction. He just told me, grab it here and hold it like this, and the water just parted. Up!
It just parted.
Up! I sure hope nothing bad happens to us in the Promised Land.
I don't think so.
So, we may have gotten a little lost. We've been wandering around this desert for 40 years. I went up to the mountain to have a little chat with God, and I come down, and the people are worshiping a calf! A golden calf! I also hit a rock in my anger, and now I am banned from the Promised Land.
My husband died. Both my sons married Ruth and Orpah, and then my sons died. God must hate me. So, I'm sending Ruth and Orpah away.
She's sending us back! Woo! Kiss her goodbye!
You know, I feel bad for her. She's all alone. You know what? I'm gonna stay.
Just take the hint. I've tried everything. She just doesn't quit!
Naomi, do you have any water?
I only respond to Mara because I'm bitter.
Naomi!
I can't hear you.
Naomi!
Blah, 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 blah.
I don't know why Naomi has been so negative. I may as well call her Nancy. You know, negative Nancy?
So we finally made it. Ruth has been actually quite helpful. She's currently collecting grain from the neighboring field.
I met this really cute guy. His name is Boaz. I'm just gonna keep doing my thing, cleaning the fields, and hoping he notices me.
Sorry, what was the question again?
Ruth?
Yeah. It's a total babe. I have a song about her, actually. Check this.
So, nothing has really been happening with Boaz, but Naomi gave me some tips and tricks on how to get a man. First, put on your best clothes. Second, put on your best perfume. Third, uncover his feet. Fourth, lie by them.
Trust the process.
Oh, hey girl, I'll be your saving grace. Let me redeem you.
So, I'm engaged.
Mara? Mara who? The Lord has blessed us. I am no longer cursed.
Man, I wish we had a king like all those other nations. They've been so good with their autocratic monarchies.
Uh-huh. Yeah, these pagan countries, they got it right.
That is so right, 100%.
I'm not so sure, but whatever you guys say.
Hey. My name's Saul.
The Lord says this is a really bad idea, and that they shouldn't do it. Like, just don't. Honestly, I don't think the people know what they're getting into. Pretty much, they have to pay taxes after this. Ugh.
But when your face looks this good, you want it on a coin. That's
I've got a pretty good streak going in battle. I've won every single time.
I've got a better streak than any other king before me. I defeated the Ammonites. Absolutely toasted the Edomites. There's literally no more Moabites. The Amalekites, well, let's just say, we take those. As far as the Philistines go, that's a quick, easy dub. The kids should try to be like Saul. I mean, they should try. Good luck, kids.
Goliath, your god is stupid. Y'all are absolutely puny. Why don't we have a little wager at this battle? One-on-one, me versus your best man.
What if I just flick a stick at your head and watch you fall like a boiled sack of potatoes?
Mm-hmm. You heard him.
Wow.
Oh, whatever. Why don't I just rip you apart like a wishbone and see which side the birds like more?
Oh! Imagine having kneecaps your size where when you bend over to touch them, things fall down like tents.
Oh! I have fought since I was a little boy. I've killed like so many people. What are you gonna do about that, boy?
Yeah.
I look after sheep. And when things kill the sheep, I kill them. So you're just gonna be like another animal!
Goliath insults, they could use some work.
You are like so small! How do you even hold a sword?
They've been going at this for like 3 to 4 hours by now.
Days ago, I was tending the sheep, right? Well, my brother, there was this big commotion. His name is Eliab. He was there, and then my other brother was like, and then he came running over to me, and that man, he told me to, like, I don't know, run back to Samuel, and Samuel was like, and sent me with this anointing oil with a super soaker, and I think I'm king now. Of course, it's not always a pretty situation. Sometimes being a king is just too hard, but not to brag, I do end up being a man after God's own heart. I do, however, want to thank Saul for his young Hebrew poetry program. It really helps me find green waters and still pastures in my life.
Captain's log. Day one, Captain Jonah in the belly of a whale, trying to escape from God. He called me to go to Nineveh, but I hate the Ninevites. So dirty sinners.
Yeah, I just like beating guys up.
I can't love them, I can't forgive them, I can't bring his message to them. Yet he still wanted me to, and he punished me in this way, leaving me stranded in this belly of a whale, this smelly belly. Captain's log, day two. It's a tough life here in the belly of the whale, but God is good. Though I disobeyed him and ran from him into this place, he's showing me that he wants to forgive even me. I've been praying. He's showing me he wants me to still go to Nineveh. I can't do it, though. I just can't do it. Captain's log, day three. I've collected my feelings and been praying a lot. And I repented to God and told him that I will go wherever he sends me, even to Nineveh. So, I know I must. I don't know how I'm gonna get out of this fish, but he will provide. He will provide.
I don't think you deserve this, but God wanted me to tell you that he wants to forgive you. If you repent, if you tell him the bad wickedness that you've done.
Never!
Oh! Huh. God told me to. Yeah, he'll forgive you.
Okay, fine. Yeah, sure.
I guess God's a lot bigger than I thought. He chased me down even though I tried to run away from him. He wanted to show this big, beautiful city, even though they're so wicked. He wanted to show them his love, forgive them. It's actually really cool that he let me be part of that. Huh. Should've just trusted him from the start.
My name is Isaiah. I'm a prophet, and God speaks through me.
My name is Jeremiah, and I am a prophet.
My name is Zachariah. I'm a prophet. This is what God has been saying to me.
I do talk with God pretty often. It's kind of fun, but not always. Right now we are being punished because the people have turned away from God. But there is hope. Let's start from the beginning.
In the beginning, God created the heavens, the earth, and the people to fill it. He made nations and kings to rule it, but he was the king of all. There is none before, and there is none after. There is no God but the Lord our God.
Even though we know God, and even though we know he is the I Am, we still shunned him and worshiped idols. What is a metal calf or a great army when weathering the wrath of God, when facing the fierce anger of God?
The Lord says he's sending a servant, someone who he's chosen. Through this man, we can find a new way to worship God.
There will no longer be a curse in the land, but we'll live in confidence in his message and in his life.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future.
There will be a voice of one calling in the wilderness. Prepare the way for the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God.
Dad, I think you need to unlock the door.
Bet you're not able to get out of this one, huh?
She's supposed to scream.
You're supposed to sorry.
Hi, my name's Avery. Avery. Not him.
Yeah, I think we just like one more shot with you. Yeah, so the garden has been great so far. I get to hang out with God all the time, which is sick. I got to name all the animals. Oh my God, Aiden!
twinkle, little.
Wait, is this like? Is it, okay, is it like a? So he's not like a people joke, or is it like? So he's not like a people joke. It's like
very monotone.
Or is it like the end of something?
It's like the end of a scene.
Okay.
Action.
So
Stop smiling, Jonah.
Or it's like going in bed.
All right, we are ready for you.
Where do you want me?
Just in this chair is good.
All right.
What is your name?
My name is John.
John, we hear you have been baptizing a lot of people?
No, I baptize people with water, but he will baptize them with the Holy Spirit and fire.
Who are you speaking of?
The Messiah. He's coming.